Talking to the legend, maybe the greatest fighter of all time, Evander, the real deal, Holyfield. So, champ, tell me about what are you doing here in Abu Dhabi?
Well, here they started boxing, and it's just programmed to help the fighter be better, you know.
There's a lot of, you fought in the Olympics, you got robbed, we all know the story.
Right.
They're fighting here to keep boxing in the Olympics. What do you think about their efforts here, AIBA and the IBA?
I think it's great. I mean, the fact of the matter for, you know, boxing is oldest sport, and to try to now just to take it out, kind of sad.
Another thing that's impressive that they're doing, they're giving out cash prizes to amateurs. I wish they had it in your day.
Well, I don't know. That issue could be a little different, but I think the art of the game is art of the game. Get the best fighters, and I really like some rules. So, you judge the fight right, and the best fighters should move on.
Now, recently you just shot a commercial with Mike Tyson. Tell me about, you haven't sat with him, I think since your fight, you haven't spent so much time with him in one day, one time. Tell me about the interaction of you and Mike.
Well, the thing is, Mike and I always been good.
You're a great dude.
Right? It never been no animosity. You know, the fact of the matter is, whoever get the best. I'm telling you, as long as you're doing it properly.
He said that your ear tastes like cherry pie?
Yeah, but I guess in that situation, I realized that when things ain't going your way, how do you get out?
Now, you were just for the Usyk-Joshua fight. You were here in Saudi. Tell me about that fight, and what do you think about Usyk and Fury?
Well, it's like it's a big guy and a little guy. Little guy faster. Big guy stronger. And so if the big guy fight the little guy fight, then the little guy gonna win. But if the big guy fight the big guy fight, he can win.
You have a major statue in Atlanta. Gervonta Davis fought there. You were at his fight. What do you think about Tank and Ryan Garcia? They're fighting this year. Two undefeated guys. They both have speed. They both have power.
Well, Tank is different. Tank kind of, he a Pernell Whitaker with power. And he got good defense. Got good defense, and he take a pretty good shot, too. Like that, so it's going to be different.
Ivan, do you have any favorite fighters today that you enjoy watching?
Tank is one of them. Tank is one of them. I'm seeing these guys that, who fights. But good fighters that, the game, they know the game. The game is not quit. Everything ain't gonna go your way, and you ain't gonna feel good all the time, but you got a good performance. You perform, because the fact of the matter is more than just you. You kind of care about the people who watch the fight as well.
People are calling you the greatest cruiserweight of all time. Do you like that title?
Yeah, well, only thing I always try to do is be the very best I could be, and it's just a matter of opinion. It's just what people think. If that's what they think, you're that for them.
Why did you have so much success against Mike Tyson where no one else except Buster Douglas were able to do what you did it like that?
Well, the art of the game is not so much just hitting hard, but the game is that you hit him more times than he hits you. Like that, and you don't get hit with them shots, then you're gonna be all right.
But why wasn't Evander Holyfield intimidated? Like every other opponent, they were broken. They came into the ring, they were scared of what's coming. You weren't scared.
Well, no, because the fact of the matter, we both human beings. The fact is that I kind of felt that, I have been through a lot of things in my life, and I can act like it ain't nothing. I'm coming everything that to be the very best in, it gonna scare you a little bit.
Sam Watson always loves to tell me, Ellie, it was me and Evander against the whole world, and we had no entre or nothing. Do you remember that? Tell me about that. You and Sam alone and everybody else, they didn't think you were going to win.
Well, the fact of the matter, you don't choose, you don't really kind of choose things is kind of choose you. And the fact of the matter, I just always want to give my very best. My very best is what God kind of give you. The thing is not to quit. If you don't quit, your chance of winning will always be greater.
My last question on that note, what advice do you have for young kids who want to follow in your footsteps and be legendary in this sport? What does it take? What are the do's and don't do's?
Listen, follow direction, don't quit. Those three things, you can be successful in anything.
All right, Evander, any message to Mike Tyson if he's watching?
So what?
Any message for Mike?
Well, you know, hey, we partners, man. I hope you're doing well.
When are you getting a face tattoo?
You know, I don't need one.
All right, there you have it. It's a very funny commercial. I enjoyed watching it. And do you get him a Christmas present yet?
Not yet.
Thanks, Evander.
You know
who I think beats Tyson Fury? A guy that you sparred named Andy Ruiz. Andy smart, he has power, very fast hands.
You know what? He, same one that I thought that could be a good fight because he quick too.
He's very quick and he's got good experience.
Yeah.
And then Wilder and him might fight. That would be interesting.
Well, I'm telling you, he's the only one I feel that can beat all of them.
That power.
I mean, you know, I sparred him.
Yeah.
I sparred him.
I remember.
And I'm like saying, I remember telling my friend, I said, look, hey, I said, this guy look like he can't do nothing. I said, boy, God, man, he got fast hand, good defense and all that. You know.
Don't judge a book by its cover.
Wait, you know. Yeah, that's how it is by anybody, because that's what kind of humility is, because you can't look at a person and tell they can't fight. Once they start moving, you can.
That's true. No, but sometimes I'm sure you've been in those situations where you went to spar someone and they're built like an action figure, like a G.I. Joe, but your skills, your stamina.
Yeah. See, but that was the whole big thing about boxing. You cannot look at a person as an individual. If you ain't never seen them box, it's different. But once you start moving, then it's show you is the guy get too close or he wait too long, he get hit. There's just so many ways you can beat a guy like that.
Which of your fights would you recommend people to watch to learn from? Like, what do you think? Is there one?
I don't really watch my fight that much too, but I tell you what, I think the greatest fight I fought with Dwight Muhammad Kwawi, it's just, you know, at that time and the 12th professional fight, even be thrown in there with that much outgoing pressure with somebody who fight like that, it was quite different.
One time you told me that Pepsi gave you a billboard and you told Coke how much they paid, and Coke were so appreciative that you were honest, they gave you like $20 million or something.
Yeah.
How much?
Well, I think $20 million.
$20 million just for being honest, for saying Pepsi only.
I don't know if being honest, but the Pepsi put the sign red by Coca-Cola building.
They were a thorn in their behind. And that was for two or something. It wasn't for a lot of money. Was it for free even?
I know.
The original.
Yeah.
They didn't pay you, Pepsi.
Pepsi didn't, because the guy asked me, he said, can I use the picture?
And you're like, yeah, you're nice.
Yeah, you can use it, man. You know, it paid off.
But honesty is the best policy, because you told Coke they didn't pay me. And I always tell people, be honest.
Yeah, pretty much. My whole thing, I always been that way, because the fact of the matter is that I wasn't expecting nothing anyway.
Okay, last thing. Did you ever dream in all of your dreams that you'll be in a Snoop Dogg song, The Real Deal Holyfield?
I didn't know Snoop Dogg.
But you're in his song.
But I didn't even listen to the rap. But, you know, the whole big thing, through time, I found out who it was and all that stuff. You know, after me, he's a real cool guy.
That makes you immortal, too, in the hip-hop.
Yep.
There you have it. Evander, The Real Deal Holyfield. Make sure to follow him on social media. Ellie Segback reporting. Back Ellie Sekback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.